my third show with X Brand. I'm so excited to be here. Are you guys freaking excited? Woo! Yes. I want to introduce to you our comic relief, Delaware Mike.
Are you a big announcer?
Yes.
Oh, you just got out of church, huh?
Yes.
Oh, you must be a big hit at the collection point, huh?
It's the richest church in town.
At least I got one. Okay. Yeah. This is my 1,000th show. All right. So, welcome to XBW. I guess all you people that couldn't afford those $300 WrestleMania tickets set it up here, right?
Is that yeah.
I got you. Well, at least it's not cold out there, right? All right. So now this is my first thing ever. They just talked me into doing this, and I figured I'd do it. So, you go to these wrestling shows and these guys have belts. They're walking around with their championship belts that they bought off the internet. You seen that? Isn't that ridiculous? I mean, that's like going to a bowling tournament with let's say you bought a bowling trophy with a 300 game winner, and then you brought it to a bowling tournament and walked around the bowling tournament. Like you sat at the snack bar with a trophy, world champion bowler, 300 average, and people are coming up to you say, did you bowl? No. Did you bowl 300? No. Well, what are you doing with the trophy? Well, I bought it off the internet, and I just like to bring it to bowling tournaments. And that's what it is. It's exactly like that, right? He's getting a kick out of it, right? But, well, I gotta make you laugh somehow. All right, now, do you want me to say a joke seriously?
Yes.
Yeah. Yes.
Okay. Any joke. No, seriously. You want to hear me say something funny, right?
Yeah.
Sure.
Okay.
Yeah.
Something funny. I'm serious. You're a tough crowd. How about I show you something funny?
Sure.
Would that be better? That because you're not into it. Okay.
Sure.
Something funny here. That's gone. Okay. Hey. I killed him in Vegas with that joke, all right? I gotta write stuff down, you see? Because I tend to forget things. What was I talking about? Oh, the jokes, okay. You got that, thank you, man. Thank you, I'll take it. All right, you know, this place reminds me a lot of WrestleMania, Lincoln Field. Doesn't it remind you of that kind of little bit? A little bit! Like there's human beings in the area. And there's like ropes. Okay. I'm glad I got one fan. I'll be signing autographs and selling cassette tapes. Yeah. I studied under Red Fox, you know that. Yeah, no, this doesn't mind me WrestleMania without the $30 parking. I'm flipping my piece of paper right here. Look. So Justin, so listen. Pinky, control yourself. Don't pee your pants when you just come here. So Justin told me, I need you here early to give me a little hand. I'm like, oh, man, come on. I'm trying to sleep. I was watching WrestleMania. You need to pick up Drake too. I'm like, all right, I'll give you a little hand. So I get here and he starts bossing me around. So I said, he said, I need a little hand. So I said, okay, fine. he didn't like it. No. But what's more ridiculous than a grown man having a little hand in his pocket? Really, seriously. Little foot. Yeah. It killed him in Atlantic City last night. No, but what's more ridiculous than having a little hand and a little foot in his pocket? A grown man. What would be more ridiculous than that? A piece of doo-doo. Oh, she's a fan. She loves it. He's good. The rest of the back crowd is not. Kelly? Control yourself. Okay. Hold on. I have anxiety, so I have an emotional support pack. You guys are giving me anxiety. I got anxiety, so I got to bring out my emotional support pack. Hold on. Yeah. It calms me down. I take it with me. Sometimes I just throw them away. But hold on a second. Now, lately, I have had an attitude. People are telling me that I have a chip on my shoulder. They say you're very cocky, you think you know everything. And they're claiming, pay attention, please. They say I have a chip on my shoulder. But I tell them, I really don't see it. Yeah, a chip on my shoulder. Okay. And hold on. I was at an event and they told me to hold, and they gave me this stub and it says, hold this stub. So I've had it for about 4 years now. I sometimes when I sleep, I cheat and I put it next to my bed, but I quickly pick it up in the morning and hold it. But I'm gonna put it back in my little case. Don't tell anybody, please. I don't want to get in trouble because it was given to me at an official event and they told me to hold on to the stub. Okay. I'm gonna have to put a nail in this coffin. This crowd is ridiculous. I'm not done with the torture because I'll start using that nail. All right, hold on a second. All right, now you get it. Now you really want me to start stepping it up and really make you laugh?
Yes.
That's gonna be tough, but right. Okay. I like to go to restaurants and eat. So I always met. You know those guys that annoy waitresses? Anybody know a waitress? Oh, you're gonna love it. Okay. So after the meal, I go, look, what's your name?
Michaela.
The meal was great, the food was great, the service was incredible. But I don't tip waitresses. I'm sorry, I just don't tip waitresses. Now what would you say to that?
I would say, I guess I'm not gonna give you
more
service.
No, I already had the service, I'm happy to be over there. Well, let's say you've already given me the check, all right? Listen, so I go, they usually say, well, we only make $2 an hour. I'm like, look, I can't tip you because every time I tip a waitress, they fall over.
Yeah.
Sometimes I like to go and I like, I walk up and they're like, would you like to see a menu? And they hand me the menu and I like, I just keep looking at it. Yeah, I just want to see it. I don't want it. I'm not here to eat. I heard about your menus. They're very interesting, so I just came in here to look at it. So I just stare at the menu. I do it until they get annoyed. It's amazing how the level of annoyance of some people are just like, I guess he just wants to keep looking at it. You know, customers always right. Like, but then, you know, or it's like, would that annoy you? It's a waitress.
No.
Okay.
No,
where do you work? Because I'm going to come there and try to. Well, I'll come down here and do it. I'm willing to do it. I'll bring in this guy with a camera and we're going to go viral.
Yes.
All right. Okay. Here's what I would like to do. You want to come? Could I have some silverware, please? And you would bring me silverware, right? Well, then I'm going to complain and I'm going to turn the silverware over and I'm going to be like, yeah, this is stainless steel. You said I asked for silverware. I was born with a silver spoon. He's laughing. This guy, he got a new fan here later. Yeah, tough guy. So it's silverware. Or I'll go to a buffet with a big Ziploc bag and like a huge Ziploc bag, and I'll be like, is it alright if I? How much is the buffet? $13.99. Do you mind if I fill this up before I leave? And like, what? Especially with like a little buffet. Like, no, you buy. I just want to take enough food to eat for the whole week. And they're like, no, you can't do that. I'm like, why not? It says all you can eat. And they're like, no, you can't do it. Okay. Or I'll do something crazy. Like, I'll ask for when they give me a straw, right? I'll go, this straw is not working. Something's wrong with it. They're like, well, want me to get you another one? I said, no, I don't want to waste the straws. And I will blow into the straw and bubbles will come up. And she goes, what are you doing? I'm like, well, it's not working. I can't get any liquid out of this. she's not supposed to blow into it. I said, well, I didn't know that. Or I'll do something crazy like, how was your meal? And I'm like, oh, this place, I'll tell you what, I gotta tell everybody about this place. I just couldn't believe this place. I said, your water is the best. I've never tasted chlorine like that. It's just incredible. I said, you know, you should bottle this stuff. You'll put everything out of business. Feel free to play with your cell phones while I'm doing my show. I should be like the big celebrities where you have to lock your cell phone and everything. Yeah, you two back there. I got you back there, yeah. Yeah, just use your phone. Now, are you taping it?
Yeah.
Yeah, I believe that. Yeah. I believe that when this is WrestleMania. Yeah, okay. Okay, what else? Oh, so I have a friend that has a shoe store. You probably don't know who he is, but anyway. I go into a shoe store and bother his workers.
Oh, I know.
And like, I'll go in there, because he lets me do it. And I'll go in there and I'll go in there and try shoes on, and I put my left foot in my right foot, and my right foot in my left, and then I'm walking along, and I'm like, and the girl goes, do you like those? I'm like, they just don't fit right. I like them a lot, they just don't fit right. And she went, you got them on the wrong foot. I'm like, oh. I said, but they need to put labels on this thing. I'm gonna kill them, they just put an L and an R in there? How am I supposed to know it? Alright, she went left foot. Okay, okay. So here's another thing I like to do. I'm a practical joker, if you can tell. So I like to go, and you can try this and you'll get a big hit. Go into a store, a department store, he likes this stuff. Go into a department store, anything, and right when you walk in, it works better if you have multiple people with you. Look up, just look up. Just stand, look up, and go, and then point, and then you'll see. I like to see if the person at the door or anybody looks up. It's amazing. Some people will stop it. Other people are like a guy dying on the ground. Some people will help him, others will just ignore it. So it's the same psychology. Yeah, that's a fun thing to do. Look up at the roof. Okay.
2 minutes, Mike.
Oh, 2 minutes. Oh. Yeah. I got tons of good. Look, hey, Justin, I need an extension. These guys are loving it.
All right. You gotta let go of the mic.
Don't raise your hand if you don't want me to not go on any longer, or raise your hand if you. And not enjoying the show, but you want me to keep going, and then, or pat yourself on the head if you want me to stop. Okay, Justin, I need another 20 minutes. What else do you want me to talk? The WrestleMania, we got the thing. I'm glad you guys are here to watch these guys, because they love wrestling, and we like wrestling, and, let me see. All right, how about I say one last joke? Alright.
Yeah.
One last joke.
Yeah.
Alright. Okay. Alright. Perry's gonna come along with his bag and you can put like anything over $20 in it. I appreciate it so I can get home with the bus and stuff. Justin's not paying me. Oh, I dropped my stuff. Oh, here's another one I like to do here on a ticket. So, like, you see this? These little tickets they give you, right? I like to go to a sporting event. I go to soccer games, and I bring this. So when I go up to the ticket thing, they're like, ticket? I'm like, yeah. And they give me this random little stick. And they're like, that's not the mission. I just bought that at the box office. They're like, really? I'm like, yeah. I'm like, they're looking all confused. And I'm like, no, it's a ticket. I'm a season ticket holder. And it doesn't work. But you know, in some places it could work. Because I've actually snuck into events. I've actually had a nasal spray and put it in my pocket and I go through the door and I'm like, yeah, where's your ticket? I'm like, I just left. I had to go get some nasal spray out of my car. And you're like, well, you're not allowed to come back. I said, I gotta go in. You're like, oh, okay, go in. Yeah, it works. Now, I wouldn't do something like that. Yeah, and these guys won't hit each other with stuff. Okay, you've been a wonderful audience, and I'll put you on the guest list when I'm in Atlantic City next week. Look for me on my cable news, on my cable special. I'm freezing up now. All right, I'm done. Thank you very much.